4 months down the line, people are saying nothing of what we expected is happening, and others are saying, bide your time, be patient, it's coming. Where are you?
Look, excuse me. Every government is voted into office to fulfill its campaign promises. That's one of the major things that people go to vote for. They want this government, this political party which was in the opposition, or this political party which is in government, which has given us, you know, presented to us this social contract that when they win the election or when we re-elect them, this is what they are going to do to alleviate our suffering, to improve our living conditions, to make sure that the cost of living is manageable. That is what people vote for. So similarly, the Zambian people, so-called 2.8 million, went out on the 12th of August to go and vote for the UPND government purely on account of the UPND promises. And the UPND promises are all documented. There is nothing that you'd refer to HH or any one of his ministers now or the party at large which is not documented, which they didn't say by word of mouth and voluntarily so to the Zambian voters. It turns out now that if there is a criminal offense that the UPND have committed is to win an election and get into government by false pretenses. As you know, under criminal law, to obtain goods by false pretenses is an offense. To obtain money by false pretenses is an offense. Maybe we should add another offense to the penal code. To get into government by false pretenses must be an offense. The leader of that party and all his followers must be locked up. They must be prosecuted and locked up. Because they get into government by fluke. The UPND government said to the Zambian people that when we win this 12th of August elections, we are going to fix everything that has been destroyed by PF. And they gave us a list. You are experiencing load shedding today because PF is mismanaging ZESCO. ZESCO can be a commercial entity which can deliver cheap electricity to you. You are paying pump prices, very high pump prices of fuel today because PF has a lot of middlemen in the importation of fuel. Your children are not able to go to school to have tertiary education. They are being thrown out at UNSA. We used to see a lot of demonstrations, you know, at UNSA, you know, students saying we are demonstrating because we've been told we can't write exams because we haven't paid the tuition fees. And HH goes to UNSA, addresses the students, and this is on camera, and he says to them, when I get into government, this will be a thing of the past. You are going to get a bursary like I got my bursary myself when I came from the village. From his own mouth. He says mini meal is going to be affordable. You are paying 150 kwacha now for a bag of mini meal. I'll make sure that it comes as low as 50 kwacha so that everybody is able and can be able to afford a bag of mini meal. So he went on and on and on. And the Zambian people, the 2.8 million, said, wow, he is a messiah that we've been looking for. Edgar and his group are monsters. Let's vote for this man. Let's vote for these men and women. They get voted into office. They turn around. And Patricia, what is annoying to people like me is how now they think they can insult my intelligence and the intelligence of the Zambian people. that now they can turn around and say, sorry, but before, you know, the pump price of fuel can go down, it has to go up. And this is coming from Mutale Narumango as vice president, a former primary school teacher, who is now trying to say to me, to lecture to me using elementary economics or civics, saying to me, I must believe her, that the increase in the pump price of fuel will lead me to a lower pump price of fuel. In the meantime, she went round together with our president and everybody else and telling us the pump price of fuel will be lowered to as low as 12 kwacha per liter.
I'll hold your thought just there, my guest, the secretary, the Rainbow Party president, join us on the other side.
Let me pick the issue of load shedding. Again, we were told by UPND that there will be no load shedding. Load shedding will be a thing of the past under a UPND government. Bali shall fix it. What we have seen in the last 4 months, Patricia, is that we have more load shedding than we had before. And you know what they do again? By way of insulting our intelligence as Zambians, they have changed the name from load shedding to load management. They are calling it load management. So that the Zambians think that we can endure load management, but we are complaining against load shedding. And yet it is one and the same thing. Households, factories, the few that we have, are still going for 2-3 days in a week without power. And if you look at the advert which they have put now for 100 seconds, you know, which is featuring the Honorable Minister of Information Media,
okay, yes.
In which they're saying, you know, we are going to employ, you know, we shall employ. They're talking about expressions of intent. They're not talking about real things. They're avoiding batteries for University of Zambia students or students in public universities. They're avoiding the issue of load shedding. They're avoiding the issue of fuel pump prices. They're avoiding, you know, all these things that impact immediately on the lives of the Zambian people. Okay? You can tell us, yes, that you have provided for the employment of 11,000 health workers and 30,000, you know, teachers. But that is in the future. The Zambian people, the 2.8 million, voted because UPND, HH promised them an immediate turnaround in their lives. If he had said to the people of Zambia, I'll turn around your lives after 4 months, I'm sure they wouldn't have voted for him. If he had said to the people of Zambia, I'll change the name of load shedding to load management, they wouldn't have voted for him. They would have realized this man is lying to us. So, for those of our colleagues, my fellow Zambians, that think, no, but this is too early. And I've listened to that narrative.
Yes.
No, but this is too early. You know, but you know. I'm saying to them, you can segment what UPND said into two or three classes. There is what they call, what you can call the immediate. The issue of fuel price was immediate. The man said, I'll drop the fuel price. I'll remove the middleman and the pump price of fuel will drop to 12 kwacha. Immediately, I get into office, he says. The issue of tertiary education was immediate. You are going to get bursaries immediately. The issue of the price of mini meal was immediate. I'll drop the price of mini meal to 50 kwacha and everybody will be able to afford a bag of mini meal. The issue of payment to farmers, okay, was immediate. The issue of fertilizer was immediate. He said the farmers are going to get their fertilizer at something like 100 kwacha. The fertilizer this year is 800 kwacha. Maybe that's why God is even annoyed with him that there is a drought in Zambia. Okay? Because he has not lied only to the Zambian people. No, he has not only lied to the Zambian people. He has lied to God as well. So, I'm saying to those that are charitable towards the UPND government, that give them time. I can tell you, once a mathematical formula is wrong all the way. Even if you are given 2 days, you know, to work it out, the answer will be wrong. And even in that group, Patricia, there are two. There are those that are diehard.
Yes.
UPND. UPND to them is not a political party. It's a religion. It's like a religious organization. It's like a sect. So it doesn't matter what sins, what iniquities, you know, or UPND commits. They will remain UPND. And there are also those that are UPND because they believed sincerely that UPND would change their lives. And I can tell you that in the next 3 to 4 months, half a year, those that belong to UPND, not as a sect, but as the Zambian people who wholeheartedly voted for the UPND because they thought that their lives would improve, they will become disillusioned and they will take a different stance.